हाय फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम। दिस इज़ द पार्ट 6, दैट इज़ लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ आवर मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग कॉम्पिटिटिव एग्जाम्स थ्योरेटिकल क्वेश्चंस एंड आंसर सीरीज ऑन इंजीनियरिंग मैकेनिक्स। सो फ्रेंड्स, लेट्स बिगिन। फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 251। द मैक्सिमम वेलोसिटी ऑफ अ पार्टिकल मूविंग विद सिंपल हार्मोनिक मोशन इज, हियर ऑप्शंस आर ओमेगा, omega r, omega square r and omega upon r. So here friends, correct answer for this question is option B, that is omega r. Next is, the maximum acceleration of a particle moving with simple harmonic motion is, here friends, these are the options and here correct answer is option C, that is omega square into r. Next is, one end of a helical spring is fixed while the other end carries the load W, which moves with simple harmonic motion. The frequency of motion is given by, here friends, these are the options and here delta is equal to deflection of the spring. And here friends, correct answer for this question is option B, that is 1 upon 2 pi and into under root of G upon delta. Next is question 254. The acceleration of a particle moving with simple harmonic motion is proportional to the displacement of the particle from the mean position. Is it true or false? So here friends, option A is the correct answer, that is it is true. Next is, the periodic time of one oscillation for a simple pendulum is, here friends, these are the options and L is equal to length of the pendulum. And here friends, correct answer is option C, that is 2 pi under root of L upon G. Next is, in order to double the period of simple pendulum, the length of the string should be halved, doubled or quadrupled. So here friends, correct answer is option C, that is quadrupled. Next is, the motion of the body from one extremity to the other is known as a beat. Agree or disagree? So here friends, answer is agree. Next is, a pendulum which executes one beat per second is known as, here friends, options are simple pendulum, compound pendulum, torsional pendulum or seconds pendulum. So here friends, correct answer for this question is option D, that is seconds pendulum. Next is question 259. If a pendulum is taken 1 kilometer below the earth's surface is a mine, it will dash in time, gain or lose? So here friends, correct answer is option A, that is gain. If a pendulum is taken 1 kilometer below the earth's surface in a mine, it will gain in time. Okay, next is, the length of a seconds pendulum is, here friends, these are the options and here correct answer is option B, that is 99.4 centimeter. When a rigid body is suspended vertically and it oscillates with a small amplitude under the action of the gravitational force of gravity, is the body is known as, here friends, these are the options and here correct option is option B, that is compound pendulum. Okay, now friends, next is question number 262. The frequency of oscillation of a compound pendulum is, here friends, these are the options and here kg is equal to radius of gyration about the centroidal axis and h is equal to distance between the point of suspension and cg of the body. So here friends, correct answer for this question is option C, that is 1 upon 2 pi into under root of gh upon kg square plus h square. Next is, the center of oscillation and center of suspension for a compound pendulum are interchangeable. Is it true or false? So here friends, option A is the correct answer, that is it is true. Next is, the equivalent length of a simple pendulum which gives the same frequency as compound pendulum is, here friends, these are the options and here correct answer is option B, that is kg square plus h square upon h. Next is the question 265. The center of percussion is below the center of gravity of the body and is at a distance equal to, here friends, these are the options, and here correct option is C, that is your answer is kg square upon h. Next is question 266. The frequency of oscillation of a torsional pendulum is, here friends, these are the options, and here correct answer is option D, that is R upon 2 pi k into under root of G upon L. So here friends, next is, which of the following statement is correct? So here first statement is, the periodic time of a particle moving with simple harmonic motion is the time taken by a particle for one complete oscillation. Next statement is, the periodic time of a particle moving with simple harmonic motion is directly proportional to its angular velocity. Next statement is, the velocity of the particle moving with simple harmonic motion is zero at the mean position. Fourth statement is, the acceleration of the particle moving with simple harmonic motion is maximum at the mean position. So here friends, correct answer for this question is option A, that is this one. The periodic time of a particle moving with simple harmonic motion is the time taken by a particle for one complete oscillation. Next is question number 268. Match the correct answers from group B for the given statements in group A in connection with simple harmonic motion. So here, first statement is, the maximum displacement of a body from its mean position is, here friends, option D is the correct answer for this question, that is amplitude. Next is, the number of cycles per second is, here friends, option A is the correct answer, that is frequency. Number of cycles per second is frequency. Next is, the velocity of the particle is zero at the, so here friends, option B is the correct answer, that is end of extremities. Next is, the acceleration of the particle is zero at the, here friends, option C is the correct answer, that is mean position. Next is question number 269. Here friends, the motion of a wheel of a car is purely translation or purely rotational, combined translation and rotational, or none of these. Here friends, correct answer for this question is answer C, that is combined translation and rotational. Next is question 217. Here friends, when a person on a bicycle drives around a circle, he has to lean to maintain equilibrium. Here options are inward or outward. So outward, or here friends, correct answer is option A, that is inward. The angle of inclination of a vehicle when moving along a circular path dash upon its mass depends or does not depend. So here friends, correct answer is option B, that is does not depend upon its mass. Okay, next is question 272. The angle of inclination with the vertical is dash if the cyclist is running at a faster speed than that when he is running at a slower speed, more or less. So here friends, correct answer is option A, that is more. Next is, the force which acts along the radius of a circle and directed towards the center of the circle is known as centripetal force. Here friends, is it true or false? So it is true. Next is, the force which acts along the radius of a circle and directed away from the center of the circle is called centrifugal force. Agree or disagree? So here it is A, that is agree. The slope on the road surface generally provided on the curves is known as, here friends, these are the options, and here correct answer is option C, that is angle of banking. So here, the slope on the road surface generally provided on the curves is known as angle of banking. Next is, Question 276. The ideal angle of banking provided on the curves on roads depends upon, here friends, these are the options, and here correct answer is option B, that is velocity square of the vehicle. Okay, now next is, when a train is rounding a curve, the side thrust on the wheel flanges is prevented by raising the outer edge of the rail. Yes or no? So it is true, that so it is yes. Next is question 278. The amount by which the outer edge of the rail is raised is known as super elevation. Agree or disagree? So here it is A, that is agree. In railways, the super elevation is expressed in terms of difference of level between the two rails. Is it true or false? So it is true. So here option is the correct answer. Next is, the super elevation is given by, here friends, these are the options, and here G is equal to gauge of the track, V is the velocity of the vehicle, and R is the radius of the circular path. So here correct answer is option C, that is GV square upon GR. Okay, next is question 281. The maximum velocity of a vehicle in order to avoid overturning on a level circular path is, here friends, these are the options, and here correct answer is option D, that is under root of GRA upon H. Next is question 282. When a vehicle moves on a level circular path, the reaction at the inner wheel is, here friends, these are the options, and here M is equal to mass of the vehicle, V is the velocity of the vehicle, H is the height of CG of the vehicle from ground level, 2A is equal to distance between outer and inner wheel, and R is the radius of the circular path. So here friends, correct answer is option C. Okay, that is mg upon 2 into bracket 1 minus v square upon v square into h upon gra. Okay, next is, the maximum velocity of a vehicle in order to avoid skidding away on a level circular path is, here friends, these are the options, and here correct answer is option C, that is under root of mu gr. Okay, under root of mu gr. Next is question number 284. Okay, the overturning of a vehicle on a level circular path can be avoided if the velocity of a vehicle is dash under root of gra upon h less than or greater than. So here option A is the correct answer, that is less than. Next is question 285. The skidding away of the vehicle on a level circular path can be avoided if the force of friction between the wheels and the ground is dash the centrifugal force. Here options are less than or greater than. So here friends, option B is the correct answer, that is greater than the centrifugal force. Next is, The total momentum of a system of masses, that is moving bodies, in any one direction remains constant unless acted upon by an external force in that direction. This statement is called, here options are Newton's first law of motion, Newton's second law of motion, principle of conservation of energy, principle of conservation of momentum. So here friends, correct answer is option D, that is principle of conservation of momentum. Okay, next is question 287. The bodies which rebound after impact are called inelastic bodies, elastic bodies, neither elastic nor inelastic, none of these. So here friends, correct answer is option B, that is elastic bodies. Okay, next is, the loss of kinetic energy during inelastic impact is given by, here friends, these are the options, and here M1 is equal to mass of the first body, M2 is equal to mass of the second body, and U1 and U2 are velocities of first and second bodies respectively. So here friends, correct answer is option A, that is M1 into M2 upon 2 into bracket M1 plus M2 into U1 minus U2 whole square. Okay, Now here, friends, next is question 289. The impact between two lead spheres. The impact between two lead spheres is approximately equal to N dash impact, elastic or inelastic. So here, friends, correct answer is option B, that is inelastic. Next is, in collision of elastic bodies, the coefficient of restitution is the ratio of the relative velocity after impact to the relative velocity before impact. Is it true or false? So it is true. The coefficient of restitution for inelastic bodies is 0 or 1 or between 1, 0 and 1 or more than 1. So here, friends, correct answer is option A, that is 0. The coefficient of restitution for inelastic body is 0. Next is, the coefficient of restitution for elastic bodies is 1. Is it right or wrong? So here it is B, that is, it is wrong. This statement is wrong. Okay. Next is question 293. Here, during elastic impact, the relative velocity of the two bodies after impact is dash the relative velocity of the two bodies before impact. Here, friends, these are the options, and here correct answer is option B, that is equal to equal and opposite to. The loss of kinetic energy during elastic impact is 0. Agree or disagree? So here it is agree. This statement is true. Next is, the loss of kinetic energy due to direct impact of the two bodies dash upon the value of coefficient of restitution depends or does not depend. So here it is depends. That is option A is the correct answer for this question. Now next is question 296. Which of the following statement is correct? Here, friends, these are the options, and here correct option is option D, that is kinetic energy of a body before impact is more than kinetic energy of a body after impact. Okay, now here, friends, next question is question number 297. Here, when two elastic bodies collide with each other, here, friends, options are, the two bodies will momentarily come to rest. After collision, two bodies tend to compress and deform at the surface of contact. The two bodies begin to regain their original shape. And option D is all of the above. So here, friends, option D is the correct answer, that is all of the above. Okay, now next is, two balls of equal mass and of perfectly elastic material are lying on the floor. One of the ball with velocity v is made to struck the second ball. Both the balls after impact will move with a velocity. Here, friends, these are the options, and here correct answer is option B, that is v by 2. A lead ball with a certain velocity is made to strike a wall. It falls down, but rubber ball of the same mass and with same velocity strikes the same wall. It rebounds. Select the correct reason from the following. Here, reasons are, both the balls undergo an equal change in momentum. The change in momentum suffered by rubber ball is more than the lead ball. The change in momentum suffered by rubber ball is less than the lead ball. None of the above. So here, friends, correct answer is option B. Okay, that is, the change in momentum suffered by rubber ball is more than the lead ball. Okay, now next is question 300. If u1 and u2 are the velocities of two moving bodies in the same direction before impact, and v1 and v2 are their velocities after impact, then the coefficient of restitution is given by. Here, friends, these are the options, and here correct answer is option B, that is v2 minus v1 upon u1 minus u2. Next is question 301. A body of mass m moving with a constant velocity v strikes another body of the same mass m moving with same velocity but in opposite direction. The common velocity of both the bodies after collision is, here friends, these are the options, and here correct answer is option B, that is 2B. Next is, a rubber ball is dropped from a height of 2 meter. If there is no loss of velocity after rebounding, the ball will rise to a height of, here friends, these are the options, and here correct answer is 2m, that is 2m, that is 2 meter. Whenever a force acts on a body and the body undergoes a displacement, then here friends, these are the options, and here correct answer is option A, that is work is said to be done. Here the unit of work in SI units is, here friends, these are the options, and here correct answer is option D, that is joule. Unit of work in SI units is joule. Okay, now here friends, next is, 1 joule is equal to, here friends, these are the options, and here correct answer is B, that is 1 newton meter. Next is question 306. Work done is said to be zero when some force acts on a body but displacement is zero. No force acts on a body but some displacement takes place, either A or B, none of the above. So here friends, correct answer is for this question is C, either A or B. Okay, now next question is question number 307. 1 joule means that, here friends, these are the options, and here correct answer is option A, that is work done by a force of 1 newton when it displaces a body through 1 meter. Okay, now next is, 1 joule is the unit of, here friends, these are the options, and here correct answer is work. The rate of doing work is known as, here friends, these are the options, and here correct answer is option C, that is power. The rate of doing work is known as power. The unit of power in SI units is, here friends, these are the options, and correct answer is option C, that is watt. 1 watt is equal to, here friends, these are the options, and here correct answer is option B, that is 1 joule per second. The power developed by a body acted upon by a torque T newton meter and revolving at omega radians second per second is given by, here friends, these are the options, and here correct answer is option A, that is T omega in watts. Energy may be defined as the capacity of doing work. Is it correct or incorrect? So here friends, it is correct. So option A is the correct answer for this question. Now next is, the unit of energy in SI units is, here friends, these are the options, and here correct answer is D, that is joule. That is, unit of energy in SI units is joule. Next is, the energy possessed by a body for doing work by virtue of its position is called, here friends, these are the options, and here correct answer for this question is option A, that is potential energy. Now next is, the kinetic energy of a body dash upon its mass and velocity does not depend or depends. So here friends, option B is the correct answer, that is depends. Okay, now next is, the potential energy stored by a spring in compression is called strain energy, yes or no? So it is yes, true. So next is, when a body of mass m attains a velocity v from rest in time t, then the kinetic energy of translation is, here friends, these are the options. Okay, and here friends, correct answer for this question is option C, that is 0.5 mv square. Okay, now question number 319. Here friends, when a body of mass moment of inertia I about a given axis is rotated about that axis with an angular velocity omega, then the kinetic energy of rotation is, here friends, these are the options, and here correct answer is option D, that is 0.5 I omega square. Okay, now friends, next is, here The wheel of a moving car possesses, here friends, options are potential energy only, kinetic energy of translation only, kinetic energy of rotation only, kinetic energy of translation and rotation both. So here friends, option D is the correct answer, that is kinetic energy of translation and rotation both. According to principle of conservation of energy, the total momentum of a system of masses in any direction remains constant unless acted upon by an external force in that direction. Here friends, is it true or false? So here option B is the correct answer, that is it is false. Okay, now next is the total energy possessed by a system of moving bodies is constant at every instant, varies from point to point, is maximum in the start and minimum at the end, is minimum at in the start and maximum at the end. So here friends, correct answer for this question is option A, that is the total energy possessed by a system of moving bodies is constant at every instant. Now next is question number 323. Here friends, the potential energy of a vertically raised body is dash the kinetic energy of a vertically falling body equal to less than or greater than. So here friends, answer A is the correct answer, that is equal to. When the spring of a watch is wound, it will possess dash energy. Which energy? So here friends, these are the options, and here correct answer is option A, that is the strain energy. Okay, next is if two bodies having masses m1 and m2, m1 is greater than m2, have equal kinetic energies, the momentum of body having mass m1 is dash the momentum of a body having mass m2. So here friends, options are equal to or less than or greater than. So here friends, correct answer is option C, that is greater than. Okay. So friends, we have completed here Mechanical Engineering Competitive Exams Theoretical Questions and Answer Series on Engineering Mechanics. Thank you friends for watching this video. Like, share and comment for this video and subscribe my channel. Thank you.